So according to Paul Ekman, with a little bit of training to recognise micromomentary expressions, people can detect deception. How do people go generally when they're trying to detect if someone's lying to them, though? Here's Darren Brown, the British illusionist.
With about three quarters of people, I can tell if they're lying pretty much instantaneously. A hand comes near the mouth, or a swallow before an answer. Is eye contact suddenly different? Does the person repeatedly look off to the left as she searches for true answers to questions, then suddenly look off to the right when she gives one particular answer?
So can people detect lies? Although there are some exceptions, which we'll talk about soon, the answer is generally that people are no better than chance at detecting deception. Bond and DePaulo reported an average lie detection accuracy for regular people of 54%. Now, it's not just regular people, though. People who work in law enforcement, such as police officers and customs officials, also perform at chance levels, as shown in research by Crout and Poe. There are some exceptions to this, such as Secret Service agents and some members of the intelligence community, as Ekman and O'Sullivan observed in 1991, but the general rule still holds. Now, why is that? Part of the reason for this is because people think a bunch of things are associated with deception. In particular, increased speech disturbances, high-pitched voice, longer latency during speech, looking away or gaze aversion, and increased body movements. You now know that voice pitch is the only one of those behaviours that's reliably related to deception. Speech disturbances and latency periods are related to deception, but the direction of that relationship changes with the different types of lies that can be told. And in fact, decreased body movements are associated with deception. So why do people think that these things are associated with being deceptive? Probably because they're all markers of being nervous, and people assume that liars will be nervous. Essentially, the problem is that people have a stereotype about what it means to look deceptive. Parts of the stereotype are accurate, for example, the higher voice pitch. However, parts of the stereotype are inaccurate, such as increased body movements. Interestingly, some of our research that was published in 2013 actually shows that people are most influenced by the parts of the stereotype that are inaccurate and largely ignore the accurate parts of the stereotype. This makes it really hard for people to accurately detect deception.